All right, guys, Dave here, and we are on location of this home transformation. And behind me are two 1,000-gallon seepage pits. We have two over here. You can see on the other side right there, we have a 500-gallon pit. And we're going to be distributing these pits in certain areas of the property. They're required for the storm water runoff that goes off the house. And even though all these years the home has had the water run straight into the ground and the surrounding property, of this particular house, now the code changes, and when you do work, this particular town wants you to install a certain amount of seepage pits. So let's turn the camera and I'll show you what we're looking at. 1,000-gallon pit right here. There's two of them. You can see the water intake outlet, and what's going to happen is we're going to take these pits, and they are going to be located. We're coming out the side of the house here with a one-car garage, an addition, a storage room, and then above it we're going to have a bedroom and a bathroom. Back here we're going to have a master bedroom suite on poles, stilts, and then over in this area here we're going to be installing the two pits. One pit is going to pick up the water runoff for the room, the master bedroom. You can see we have marked out here in orange, this is where the piers are going to be. There's three piers, and so we're going to have the water runoff from this master bedroom run into one of the pits over here. And then the garage, we're gonna have the water runoff coming over here into the second pit. Okay, so here is a 500-gallon pit. This is gonna go in this area right over here. And when we build our dining room extension off to the right side of the house here, you can see how the leader comes down now. Currently the water just spreads out on the property and goes down into the grass. Now what they want this pit in the ground, and we're gonna direct the new leader pipe into this pit, which will take care of the third addition that we're adding onto this home. This home's gonna get completely transformed. All new siding, roofing. We're adding a second garage there. We're doing a front porch. So there's gonna be a little foundation in the front for the porch, foundation in the side for the dining room. All right, so we have the excavator on site. He started the digging process. We have a pit in the back that's gonna handle two 1,000-gallon pits, and the excavation, the hole in the ground is about maybe 15 feet long, almost eight to nine feet deep, and about 10 feet wide. Okay, so there's our first pit in the front yard that we're gonna be placing shortly. We have the excavator on site. And let me show you the hole in the ground needed to handle the pits. So there are the pits. Now they're hooking them up. And I'll show you the process right now. All right, so right now we just put a 3-inch shoulder stone along the base. And we're gonna chain that up. We're gonna lift that with the backhoe, and we're going to place that first pit right in here. It's going to sit on this base. You can see the remnants of this, of the sprinkler system, previous drainage system that we noticed goes around the property, all leads to this area, so it's going to work out well. We drop the first pit in. That's a 1,000-gallon unit, and now what we're going to do is we're going to spread about 1.5 feet of stone, a 3-inch shoulder stone, right around the perimeter. We have fabric wrap, and this is almost a filter. Any water coming in and going out is going to get filtered by this paper. And right now we're just backfilling the shoulder stone around the perimeter. And then we're going to get to the top of the tank. Inspector's going to come here. He's going to look in that tank, make sure it's not filled with water. And then that gives us the green light to put the dirt back on top. And we have an inspection set up for about 3 hours from now. All right, so here's the first pit. We have it backfilled, about 1.5 feet of stone. Now we're gonna excavate this area right here. We're gonna put the second 1,000-gallon pit right in there. We put more filter fabric. We'll put the base of the stone and set the tank right on top of the base. You can see we have about 1 foot or so of shoulder stone down below. We sit the tank on top of that. We level it all off. This is how we install the seepage pits. All right, guys, so we are loading up the base now. We have the three-quarter shoulder stone, and we're just, you can see we're putting more shoulder stone on the bottom. And this is gonna hold the second tank that we're gonna connect. He's setting up the chains, and we're gonna lower that down shortly. All right, guys, so we're gonna chain up the 1,000-gallon tank. You can see the hooks. There are hooks on the tank right here. There's three of them. And then we attach the chain. We're gonna lift that up. We're gonna lift that up and get it right over to the vicinity. Drop it in, keep clearance. You can see the clearance around the edge. We're maintaining about a foot and a half. And here we go. So we're gonna drop that in. We're gonna face the porthole. There's two of them. I'm gonna face one of them going straight in so that we can run our piping in. Okay, we're dropping more filter fabric in. He's got the truck all filled up with three-quarter shoulder stone. So it's just a process, keeping it nice and organized. And now he's gonna start dumping the shoulder stone around the perimeter against the filter fabric. The guy's gonna stand on it until we get some stone on there so that the filter fabric doesn't fall. All right, just filling up, putting the stone around the sides. Inspector's gonna come here. He's gonna look at all this while it's open. All right, so now we're in the front of the house. We have a 500-gallon pit that is gonna pick up the water runoff for the brand new dining room that we're putting in on the right side of the house. So that pit is gonna go in this hole right here. We're gonna set it up the same way. We're gonna put a base of three-inch shoulder stone. We're gonna drop the pit in, put the filter fabric around it. All right, guys, we got the pit in, filter fabric's in. All right, guys, it's the end of the day, and we just came back to the site. We had our seepage pits inspected, and this is the first one in the front of the house. I'm going to turn the camera on. I'll show you the three pits in Bergen County, New Jersey, that we just installed today. So there's the machine, and as we look down here, this is the front yard. This is a 500-gallon pit. We just passed inspection, and you can see, again, it's a template of the ones in the back that we showed earlier. The fabric, silt fence that we have here, and the fiber fence, and then we have the stone, three inch stone going around the perimeter. You got to maintain about a foot and a half going around, and we also have about a foot underneath the whole pit itself. This pipe will be our connection, and then over here we're going to have a dining room coming off the side of the house, and then we will pipe over to that drain with the leaders for this side addition. Let's go in the back. We have two 1,000-gallon pits we'll take a look at. All right, guys, so we just had the inspections. That wraps up the installation of the seepage pits. And tomorrow we're gonna excavate this home, the three additions. We have some pier footings in the back. We have a garage footing here. And then on the other side, we have a dining room footing. So we're gonna make our way over here tomorrow. And for about 3 hours, we're going to excavate and get things lined up, because 2 days later, after the weekend, the masonry crew will come in here, set up the forms, and then we'll be able to get inspection and then pour for the footings and get our block work going. So stay tuned. And if you and your family have any questions, give us a call at 201-774-3733. You could email us right here, info@pangionedevelopers.info. And again, our number 201-774-3733. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, if you're interested in information on how to hire a contractor, I put together a list. Click on the link down below. You'll get that information for free. Again, click on the link down below and you'll get that information on how to hire a contractor. You'll get it for free. Thanks.